the Lord to have mercy on all who sing unto him. Alleluia. Now, blessed Mother, with grateful heart,
Christ is risen.
Christos
Voskrese. Christos Anesti.
So, a word about our mother, Matrona. It's more than one word. You know that by now. I actually was able to find a very interesting article from a church newspaper in Moscow from 1999. In fact, this was published just a few weeks after Saint Matrona was glorified, not made a saint. God and she did that. But the church, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, gives glory to God through her incredible example. The church glorifies the saint. The church canonizes saints, which means the church makes normal what God already knows and has done. Normalizes that reality for all the rest of the church to see, behold, and to honor and imitate. So, this article is called The Blessed Matrona of Moscow Glorified, and it's from 1999, as I said. It's a church newspaper in Russia. On May 2nd, 1999, an event which was eagerly awaited by Orthodox faithful took place in Moscow. The Venerable Blessed Matrona of Moscow, whose earthly name was Matrona Dmitrievna Nikonova, was glorified among the ranks of saints. Blind from birth, as a child, she received the gift of spiritual sight from God. Through her prayers, the sick, the suffering, those struggling with mental and physical illness were healed. Following her righteous death, people came daily to her grave at the Danilov Cemetery, and having prayed to her, received comfort and help. In 1997, 2 years before she was glorified, with the blessing of His Holiness Patriarch Alexei, the pious woman's revered remains were transferred from the Danilov Cemetery first to the Danilov Monastery and then to the Cathedral of the Holy Protection Women's Monastery in Taganka. Since that time, pilgrimages of thousands of faithful who revered the venerable and righteous Matrona, or Matronushka, I can almost say that, Matronushka, as she was affectionately known among the people. Today, the monastery receives hundreds of letters from those who are suffering, who are in need of spiritual comfort and healing from maladies, asking for prayers to the Blessed Matrona. Some letters are addressed directly to her. According to Mother Theophania, Abbess of the Holy Protection Cloister, many of the petitioners, that's letter writers, received speedy and effective help from the Venerable Matrona. Again, this is before she was glorified. This letter writing and miracles were taking place. A special book is kept by the sisters of the monastery for recording incidents of miraculous intercessions and divine help in the prayers of the Venerable Matrona. The residents of the Holy Protection Monastery are themselves frequent witnesses of this, firmly believing that it is the Venerable Matronushka herself who aids them in the cloister's restoration. The synodal commission, that is the commission appointed by the synod bishops of the Moscow Patriarchate for the canonization of saints by direction of His Holiness, inquired into the possibility of glorifying the righteous Matrona. In examining the selfless life of the pious Matrona Dmitrievna Nikonova, her popular devotion and miracles, the commission could find no obstacles to her glorification among the ranks of locally venerated saints. People from all over Moscow came to the Holy Protection Monastery on that May morning. Many carried flowers. The cloister's courtyard was filled. Following the early liturgy and the protection of the cathedral's lower church, the final panahida was, listen to this, the final panahida was celebrated for Matronushka. The majority of the faithful remained at the monastery to participate in the solemnity of the righteous Matrona's glorification. Remember that. The final panahida, the last prayers for Matrona took place that morning. We go on. The line of people wishing to pay their respects to Matrona's relics kept growing. Beginning with the center of the monastery courtyard, the line wound halfway around the large cathedral and then approached the cathedral doors. Those who were going to the later liturgy were given candles, with a note, please place them there as relics. Patriarch Alexis celebrated the festival of divine liturgy in the cathedral's upper church, joined by other hierarchs and clergy. Before the liturgy, the clergy bring in the reliquary covered with a red paschal, that is possible, pall, cloth. containing the venerable blessed Matrona's remains, placing them to the right of the soleil. Soleil is the flat place where I stand on top of the steps, this side of the Akathist, so the relishable place over here. The clergy sing the final prayer for the repose of the soul of God, the soul of God's servant Matrona. There is a final chance of memory eternal, Vishnaya Panya. Then, His Holiness the Patriarch pronounces the decision for the canonization and inclusion among the locally revered saints of the Blessed Matrona of Moscow. Beneath the cathedral rafters, there was the sound of youthful voices singing for the first time the Japari to the venerable saints Matrona. Everyone present in the cathedral joined the primate of the Russian Church, the Patriarch, in singing, "We magnify thee, the holy, blessed, venerable Matrona, and we venerate thy holy memory." And how about that? They went from praying for Matrona to praying to Saint Matrona. What a powerful experience, a powerful story of the recognition of one already sainted in heaven. Admission to the cathedral's smaller upper church was limited on that day. Most of the people remained outside the cathedral walls, listening to the patriarch's service through speakers. It sounds familiar, like live streaming, only they didn't have any video. When there was a momentary silence in the cathedral, one could hear through the open windows a many-voiced chorus from outside singing, "We magnify thee, the holy, blessed, venerable Matrona." The day was overcast and cold. A shower of hail fell three times. That also sounds familiar. But the desire of the Orthodox people to venerate the relics, to participate in a magnificent spiritual event, was stronger than the human desire to seek shelter from the bad weather. By midday, the sun unexpectedly shone through the gray clouds. Its rays lit up the subdued crowd and brightened the red paschal vestments of the clergy, escorting Archbishop Arsenio of Istra, who came down the cathedral steps to bring Holy Communion to the faithful gathered in the courtyard with Christ's sacred mysteries. Following the liturgy, the patriarch, escorted by the clergy, came down into the cathedral's lower church. There, before the relics of the venerable Blessed Matrona, to the right side of the soleil, he celebrated the first service of intercession to the newly glorified saint. Following that, the patriarch blessed the foundation of the monastery bell tower that had been destroyed during the years of persecution. He greeted his flock in the courtyard on the occasion of the glorification of the venerable Matrona of Moscow, who, said His Holiness, we believe, was and will continue to be the prayerful protector of our long-suffering people, our church, and our fatherland. The festival is over, the article concludes, but the experience of the wonder that took place has not left the soul. One more star is shining in the church heavens. One more of God's favorites has been added to the ranks of prayerful protectors of our ancient capital. This, of course, is written in and about Moscow. Endless masses of Orthodox faithful are going to the Holy Protection Monastery to pay homage to the Venerable Matrona of Moscow, believing in the power of intercession, the power of her intercession, recalling her own words. All and every one of you, come to me and tell me about your sorrows. I will see you and hear you and will help you. May she always pray to God for us, particularly as we struggle as a church, as a diocese, and as a nation, and the world. Last thing I want to say is a couple of our friends from a previous parish had brought Matush Tamara and me a little vial of the oil, a mirror from the Lampada. The Lampada is at the relics of St. Matrona. And when my parishioners come back to church, and come back, if you remind me, I'd be very happy to anoint you with some of that oil, asking, of course, once again, her holy prayers. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ is risen.